build out a simple workflow in Document Locator's Workflow Route Manager. This will be a request for approval. It'll have a notification step, a correction step, a manager approval step, a final approval by the controller. Once approved, it'll move to the approved folder, and upon final approval, it will notify the submitter that their request has been approved. So to start the workflow and build it, we will go new workflow. We'll give the workflow a name. We'll call it payment request approval. Give it some instructions. We want to assign a manager to the workflow. So in this case, I'll assign to the workflow, I'll assign the systems administrator in this case. So the next thing we want to do is put the security on who gets to use and work with the actual workflow. And so we have all the users in here. We might want to take the users out and just add in the folks that we want to make this particular workflow available to. We'll say accounting group in this case. So now we have the parameters set for the new payment request approval workflow. Next thing is to add this step. The first step we're going to add from the step wizard is we're going to add a notification step. And what we want to do on this notification step, the idea here is to notify the submitter if the notify the manager if the workflow is not steps are not completed in time. So we'll just say notification to manager. You can name these steps whatever you would like. Give some instruction. We'll just say task not completed in time. Now I'm going to make this what we call a variable, a step condition. So we only want to process this one if a certain task is not completed in time. Now we can select and create our own notification templates. We'll just go say that the task not completed in time. The next action is now to select who we need to notify. Well, I want to notify the submitter manager if it's not completed in time. So from here we can go on and complete the steps. We have our first step to notify the manager. It's a conditional step. The next step I'd like to add, step number two, will be an edit step. That's also going to be a conditional step. So what we want to do is basically if the person who's submitting the request, if it's rejected, we want to come back to them with the reason why. So we're just going to have a single user notification and we'll just say, edit for correction. And again, you can have instructions down here on what specifically they need to do. Edit for correction per manager note. That's also a conditional step. We'll go through, we can again put in these different notifications that we might need to put in for the messages, kind of the reminder messages, if you will, and notification message itself. Now, we're not going to assign a template, which could be a reference document, to this particular step, but we do need to assign who needs to be notified if it's rejected, their request. So we select the actual submitter of the document. We can have an alternate for them, and we can put some conditions on how many days. Maybe we give them X amount of time to finish their corrections and remind them a certain period before. So now we finish that next step to edit for correction. Now we want to go ahead and have our first approval. So we'll come up and we'll select a preliminary approval step, and we'll have, basically in this case, we're going to have a manager approve it. And we'll give instructions here. Now we can also do some other actions here, only process this step from the condition, but no, we don't need to do that. We're basically just saying that we want this person to be the person that approves that. And we'll just, for sake of speeding things up, we'll just copy this information in on the reminder message. You go to the next step. Now here's where we want to assign some policies or procedures, some basic instructions about what should occur with that particular document. So I'd like to go ahead and put in one of our payment policy documents that the approver can reference. So they can open these up while they're doing the workflow task to reference that. Well, I want this to go to the submitter manager. And I can allow that manager to delegate that task. Maybe when the manager receives it, they were allowed to pick another user to actually approve that work for them. We can have an alternate in case it does time out and they're not available. We can have an alternate pick up that task for them. We're going to give him 4 days or her 4 days to approve it and notify them 3 hours prior. We can put these conditions. Well, if they don't approve it, I do want to add a condition. If they decline it, in other words, I want it to go back to the submitter if that step is declined. So now we finish that manager approval step. So the next thing that can occur is we can go in and do a final approval step. Again, we just come over, select the step types. This would be a final approval. Here we might have the controller do the final approval. Give some instructions. And then if it's rejected, we can put that condition that it will go back to the previous submitter with the information. You also put the template for the instructions as we did before. Here I want to go ahead and have the controller be the approver. I can have an alternate. I can give the controller some time if I need to. I do want to add a condition. If it's declined approval, I want to go back one step to the manager who submitted it for review. We now finished a controller approval step. So after it reaches the final approval, what I'd like to do next is to add a step, which is called a custom action step. These come with Document Locator. You have a variety of them. We want to do a move the file. In other words, after it reaches final approval, I want to automatically move into an approved folder. So I'll just say move file to, you know, approved folder. We don't really need to do a notification there. So now I need to add in where I want to move it to. So step six, where I set the custom action parameters, over here what I need to do is just say what's the folder that I want to move the approved file into. So I would probably, let's say in this case, we'll move it in when it's approved. We'll move it into an approved folder, that approved request folder. So after it's approved, it'll automatically move there. I don't really need to do a notification on that one. And then the final step is to notify the submitter that their work has been completed. So we'll just, in this case, simply add another notification step to notify the submitter. We can say, you know, that it's been approved. And from here, we can, you know, put that message in. Let's go back, make sure we put the message in. That's the message they'll be notified, and of course it's the submitter that I want to be notified, so I can just select the submitter. I can select other folks too, as you can see, but we're going to let them know. When we complete this workflow, now we can now go out and test and validate it. We'll save it, and that workflow will be ready for our use.